So before talking about the life in Germany, you can look at the admission requirements in the first video, in the information card and also in the description below. And you can have a look at the education system. That was the second video. And now we are moving for the third video, that is the life in Germany. So let's start with housing. That is the biggest challenge that people now face in Netherlands. I don't know about Germany because students are increasing a lot and
houses are limited.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah. So what is the like the housing like covering or like how much is the rent and what is the utilities, whether it is furnished, unfurnished, internet and all these kind of things.
Yes. Like if you are coming to Aachen, then you are really lucky regarding housing because it won't be much expensive in comparison to cities like Berlin and Munich.
Okay.
Yes. Like you are coming to a good university, but you are paying less for a rent.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But yeah, getting a house is difficult if you are coming from India right now. Mm-hmm. Like it's very difficult. Like the landlords don't give the houses for rent without meeting the students in person. That's okay. A problem.
And so, you also need a German bank account or that's not compulsory?
That's not compulsory for housing. Like you just have to pay the rent and caution deposit to the house, like to the owner. So mainly like when you come here, usually people find some advertisements on the Facebook group.
Mm-hmm.
Like someone is subletting their room for 1 month or 2 months.
Okay.
So you can just pay them from India and you can come. Then 1 or 2 months can buy you some time to find a better and cheaper option here.
Okay.
And I would advise like not to pay someone for the whole year, like the caution and sign a contract for the whole year before coming to Germany.
Okay, because you might not like it and be satisfied with it.
Exactly.
And what is the like average range of rent for students?
Rent, like if you are lucky to get a dorm in the university, you can get up to 200 to 250 euro.
Oh, that's super cheap as compared to Netherlands.
Yes.
But what do you mean by dorm? It's similar to hostels that we have in India or is it something different like an apartment, but it's inside university, very close to the university?
There are two kinds. Okay. Yeah, those are controlled by the university.
Okay.
And they are not inside the university because there is no university campus.
Yeah. That is what is also missing here, like not like US or India that...
Yeah.
Some apartments are very close to the university, managed by some housing organizations in Netherlands who are who have tie up with universities.
Yes.
But I don't know about the...
Like the university is spread throughout the city. And yeah, these dorms, there are two kinds. Like we have single rooms and we have vegas.
So single room is like the private accommodation.
Yes. Like you have 10 to 15 rooms sharing one kitchen. And three bathrooms, like hostels in India, but they are much better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and there are shared apartments, which are called WGs in Germany.
Okay.
So basically you have 4 to 5 guys living in one apartment, one flat,
mm-hmm.
and you share 2 bathrooms and 1 kitchen, something like that.
Okay.
Yes. And if you're getting a private apartment, like the landlords who stay in Aachen, like the average rent is around 300 to 350.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you are searching like well, then you will get within 350 and some super expensive apartment like rooms may go up to 400. Yeah, it's like that.
Okay. And what about the like should they choose furnished or unfurnished houses in the beginning?
Whatever I said, like these rents are for furnished apartments.
Okay.
And there are rarely any rooms you will get
So it's not that famous like unfurnished.
Yes. But still if you get unfurnished you may find it cheaper and you can buy the items again like you have done here.
But I have also advised people that if you are coming for the first time, then I would not recommend an unfurnished home. Once you get used to maybe a year or few months, then you can have a lot of options and liberty to do whatever you want.
Exactly, yeah.
And the internet and everything is also included in your apartment price.
Yeah, most of the rent I said is warm rent. There are two kinds of rents.
Mm-hmm.
There is one cold rent and warm rent. Warm rent means electricity, water and
all
internet.
Type of utilities like energy and everything.
Yeah, they are included with it. And cold rent is like empty naked house, you have nothing, like It's furnished, but without electricity and all.
Ah, okay.
That's
okay.
Cold rent.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's a good point to know.
Yes.
And what about the price of food? Like, if you cook yourself, or maybe if you eat outside occasionally, or...
If you eat outside, it will be really expensive. If you are an Indian student, like, you don't want to... You may spend up to like 120 to 150 euros if you eat outside every day.
Okay.
It's really expensive. And if you cook, you can manage within 60 euros.
Okay.
So, cooking is really...
I think
really,
it's almost 50% cheaper than what we have in Netherlands. Because
Yes. If
we cook ourselves during our student life, then the cost was between 80 to 100 or 100 to 120 euros. And eating outside was about 200.
And it also depends on what you eat.
Yeah, that's like, also true.
Yes. Like, depending on your diet, it'll... But you can mostly manage at max within 80 euros
if you cook yourself. So, yes. I always give this advice. Always try to...
Cook yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what about the insurance and travel costs?
Yes. Insurance costs, usually the most popular opinion is TK. People take the insurance of TK.
Okay.
It's a company, health insurance company.
But if you are coming from outside, then you would recommend to take only German insurance. I mean, inside Germany, not
yes.
like take from abroad, and
no.
that will be a big problem.
Yes, that's a big problem. And it costs around 90 euro. Yeah, that's fixed. Like, it may increase in next few years, but it's currently it's 92 euro. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. So that's something you have to do. That's compulsory for everyone. It's recommended, the insurance. Yeah.
Okay. And what about the travel costs?
Yeah, travel costs. If you are studying at RWTH, then you will get a semester ticket.
Okay.
Yes.
I think I have heard also people studying in Berlin. I had some friends.
Yes.
Maybe I'll do interview later.
Yeah.
So they also had some student discount cards, and they can use it to in certain
there
regions.
There is one important point which we missed we didn't miss actually. About the tuition fees.
Okay.
Yes. We don't have tuition fees, but every semester we have to pay a semester contribution.
Okay. That's
and, yes.
How much is it?
That's like? Around 285 euros per semester.
Okay.
That we have to pay. And with that semester contribution, you get a semester ticket. So that means...
Ah, okay. So they use it to
yes.
give you back yourself.
Exactly.
But anyways, it's fine. At least
yes.
you can travel and...
Yes.
Because here the public transport is really expensive, and I have made many videos. You can check it if you want to see our Netherlands. You have this OV chip card, but still you don't have any student discount unless you are a Dutch citizen.
Yes. So the transport part is mostly taken care of by the semester ticket.
Okay. Mm. And what about the miscellaneous things like hair cutting, books and stationery, fitness, other expenses?
Yes. Books, you don't need to buy any books in most of the courses. Like, you get the study material from the university.
Ah, okay.
They give you soft copies of the presentations, and e-books also you get from the university. But some cases they may have some material, study material, but they sell it for cheap. They sell the photocopies for like minimal amount, like 8 or 10 euros for
okay,
a book.
That's nice.
Yeah, you get that from the
because
university.
Normally, trust me, books here are really expensive. You buy
yes.
the real books with the from the authors. Like.
Yeah, yes.
And
regarding...
Hair cutting. I mean,
like,
this is a very trivial topic, but I just always... put that in the
if you are a genius like him, you can cut your hair yourself. Yeah, but like if you are like me, you have to spend like 9 to 10 euros per haircut. It's
okay.
like standard.
I mean, here it is 10 to 15 euros, but I have never been to a hair salon. I say this many times.
Yeah.
And I cut my hair myself using a trimmer. You can see it now also.
Yes, you just need a good friend and a trimmer.
And I was using that, but after coming here, I'm doing it myself, even the back part.
Yes.
So you can imagine.
He's a genius.
Yes. And what about the fitness and other expenses if
yes.
anyone wants to do any sports or...
Yeah, if you go, you can go join the university gym for like 120 euros for a semester.
So each university have this yearly, I think it's yearly, right?
It's per semester.
Oh, semester, okay.
Yeah.
Because here we have 100 euro yearly, but that was 2 years back. So I don't know what is it now.
Yes. Like it's actually cheap, you can say. Like for 6 months.
Compared to a private gym or something.
Yes,
you join.
Yes.
And you have other also, right? Like apart from the gym, you can also do some activities.
There are a lot of activities.
Table tennis and sports.
In RWTH, you can learn dance, you can learn salsa, you can do calisthenics, like you can take boxing coaching or martial arts, anything you want.
Oh my God.
Like the sports facility is really good at RWTH.
I think and you are learning salsa. Right?
Yes. I'm learning. And the most important thing is you are not coming here just to study. Like you should learn something else as well.
At least immerse yourself a little bit in the culture or maybe the surrounding or the people or something like that.
Yes, and there is a lot of scope. You can socialize with people, make new friends. So these activities are a good way to socialize. Yes.
Okay. And what about the, I mean, we will discuss about this later in details, but now just say one line, because I always say that you need German to be in Germany.
Yes.
And so what about that, like the ambience and the language barrier, like the environment?
Yes, if you want to socialize, you need German. Yes, like before I said that you don't need German for your courses. But to socialize, like I can say from my example, this is like kind of embarrassing. I have been 1 year in Germany. I still don't have close German friends. This is really sad. Like I have few friends and they are good in English. That's why they are close friends of mine. I mostly have international friends. But Germans actually, I don't know, they don't prefer to speak English a lot. So it becomes a barrier. Yes. So if you want like to socialize, learning German is good. You can learn after coming here as well, but pay some time, pay effort for that. Yes.
Okay. And what about the, have you ever faced or heard from anyone any racism or any kind of?
To be honest, like it won't affect you, but some places you may find a bit of racism,
like a side effect or something.
Like mostly if the people are,
is it like unintentional and you feel it, or
it's unintentional?
Okay.
Like it's not like in the university you won't feel a bit, like they are really professional, you won't find any kind of racism.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are meeting the commoners of Aachen, like the citizens who are not related to the university, racism a bit, it may be there. You can feel sometimes. Yeah.
Okay. I think that happens
everywhere. Yeah, it's normal.
So
but it doesn't
feel it like.
Like yeah, it's not like someone is going to kill you or something.
Yeah.
Like, it's not like that. But yes, a little bit is there.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what about the, like the, do they accept cards in most places? Is it like mostly cashless transactions or? Everything is, you also have some parts where you need to carry a lot of cash with you, like
see mostly in the supermarkets and like the common places they take cards, but in some restaurants they take only cash.
Okay.
Like most of the restaurants I have been to, they take cash.
And what about the final thing, like when you have all these things going on simultaneously, how do you manage your time? Because time management is a art which is very difficult to teach someone, but it is very you learn it once you do it. So maybe you can share your 1 year experience, how you do time management.
Actually, like you actually have to make a schedule and stick to it. You actually can't just take a lot of things at a time and decide doing, like I have learned from my mistakes. Like in the first semester, I was like, I will learn German, I will learn dancing, I will go to gym, I will study as well, I will do everything. I was like that. But gradually I saw that, I found that it's really difficult. You can't do that. You have to pick selective things, choose a certain number of things and focus on that. You have to, you actually have to plan your weeks.
Mm-hmm.
You can't just do things at your whim. Like, I want to study now, let's study. Not like that. I want to go to the gym, I'll go. No, you have to stick to the schedule.
Okay.
Else it's very difficult to manage the time. Yeah.
Just to add to it, like here, that is a good thing I noticed, because Dutch people do very good time management. They have something called the agenda. So they have always put, like even when you go out for a dinner, they put that in the agenda or maybe in the calendar, Google calendar, and they allocate a specific time slot for even those leisure activities. So in that way, you might find it very ridiculous, but it helps a lot to plan out your days and how you're spending your time and deciding which things prioritize more and less. Yes. And all these things.
Yes.
So speaking about the language barrier, we'll go in depth in the next video.
Yes.
About the requirement of German in teaching, jobs and living. So stay tuned for the next video and check it in the recommendation after the video. So stay tuned.